Hello and welcome back to another timing system installation video by Cloyes. I'm Cody Smith, Technical Product Director for Cloyes. In this video, we'll be demonstrating timing system removal and installation in Honda K24 engines. The Cloyes product offerings cover the 2.4-liter four-cylinder engines found in Honda and Acura vehicles from 2002 through 2015. This includes Honda Accords, CRVs, Elements, and Civics, along with Acura TSXs and ILXs. The K24 has also become a popular engine swap for hot rodders and is being used in many forms of motorsports across the world. Cloyes offers two different timing kits for the K24, the 9-0711S kit for the earlier K24A engines and the 9-0711SA kit for the later K24Z engines. The kits are both very similar with only small differences to the balance shaft tensioner, primary tensioner, and the primary tensioner guide. The engine we have on hand today is an earlier K24A, so we will be installing the 9-0711S in this video. But the installation procedure is the same for the K24Z engines and their 9-0711SA kit. No matter which kit is right for your engine, they will come with the primary and balance shaft chains, primary and balance shaft tensioners, all the necessary chain guides, the exhaust camshaft sprocket, the crankshaft sprocket, and the balance shaft sprocket. These two kits are also available without sprockets by adding an X to the end of the kit numbers. To confirm which kit is correct for your vehicle and additional product information, please visit our part finder at cloyes.com. The primary time and chain components in the K24 engine can be removed and replaced with the engine in the vehicle. However, to perform the complete repair, including the balance shaft oil pump chain components, the oil pan must be removed, which requires the engine to be lifted to make clearance to remove the pan. During disassembly, before you remove the harmonic balancer, rotate it so the top dead center mark on the balancer, which is the left notch of the two side-by-side notches, aligns to the pointer on the timing cover. You can then remove the balancer, just be careful not to lose the crankshaft key. You can remove the VVT solenoid, the valve cover, the oil pan, and the timing cover to access the components. With the covers off, but before removing any components, ensure that the reference marks of the camshaft sprockets are aligned between the two cams and the timing marks of the sprockets are up. The reference marks are the dash marks on the sprockets, and the timing marks are the dots. If you properly rotated the balancer before disassembly, these marks should either align or they will be exactly 180 degrees out. If necessary, slide the balancer back onto the crankshaft with the crankshaft key and rotate one full revolution so the camshaft marks align and the crankshaft sprocket mark realigns to the arrow on the engine at 12 o'clock. This is the position the engine needs to be in to service the timing components. If you're servicing the timing system due to a system failure, you may need to rotate the crankshaft slightly until no pistons are at top dead center. Then rotate the cams to properly align them, then bring your crankshaft back up to the top. Just be careful when rotating the individual shafts due to possible piston-to-valve contact. This is an interference engine. With the shafts all located correctly, we can now start the disassembly. Start by removing the primary time and chain tensioner followed by the three primary chain guides. You can then remove the crankshaft reluctor, the primary chain, and then the exhaust camshaft sprocket. To remove the exhaust camshaft sprocket bolt, you can insert an appropriate size punch, drill bit, Allen wrench, or bolt into the hole in the back of the camshaft. This will hold the camshaft while you break the bolt loose and will be needed later to properly torque this bolt. If you plan on servicing the camshaft phaser, now is the time to do so. Use the same tool to hold the shaft while removing and replacing the bolt. The camshaft phaser bolt torques to 83 foot-pounds. You can now remove the balance shaft oil pump chain and components. Start by removing the tensioner, then the guide. Next, remove the balance shaft sprocket bolt. You will once again need a tool to hold the shaft in place while removing this bolt. The same tool you used on the camshaft will likely work, but in this case, the screwdriver works better so you can hold on to it. Insert the tool into the appropriate hole in the bottom of the balance shaft assembly and remove the bolt. With the balance shaft sprocket bolt removed, you can remove the chain, crankshaft sprocket, and the balance shaft sprocket as an assembly. Before we reinstall the timing components, let me show you how the primary time and chain tensioner is activated and deactivated. The tensioner has a ratcheting mechanism that does not allow the tensioner to be compressed fully once activated. This feature assists the hydraulic function of the tensioner by mechanically restricting the range of motion. The tensioner must be in the deactivated state in order to install. If you need to deactivate an activated tensioner, just hold the retaining plate to disengage the ratcheting teeth and compress the piston. Then allow the piston to extend about 3 clicks and compress again until the retaining plate aligns to the pin location. Then insert the pin. If you do not have an activation pin, a paper clip or a thumbtack will work. The tensioner is now ready to be installed. If you need to reinstall an activated balance shaft tensioner, you can deactivate it by simply compressing and reinstalling the clip. Start the installation process by assembling and properly timing the crankshaft sprocket, balance shaft chain, and the balance shaft sprocket. The double marked links of the chain will straddle the timing mark on the balance shaft sprocket, and the single marked link aligns to the mark on the back row of the crankshaft sprocket. With the marks aligned properly, slide the assembly onto the engine and ensure that both sprockets index onto their shafts properly. If necessary, you can rotate the shaft slightly either way to make this process easier. With the marks still properly aligned and the sprockets indexed, reinstall the balance shaft sprocket bolt and torque to 33 foot-pounds. You can now install the chain guide and tensioner. Torque the bolts to 8.7 foot-pounds. Recheck that your timing marks are still properly aligned and activate the tensioner by removing the activation pin. If the crankshaft moved during this process, you can now realign the sprocket mark to the mark on the block. Next, install your exhaust camshaft sprocket and torque the bolt to 53 foot-pounds. We are now ready to install the primary chain. You will find 3 sets of marked links on the chain, 2 sets of double marked links, and 1 single marked link. The double marked links will straddle the timing marks on the 2 camshaft sprockets, and the single marked link will align to the timing mark on the front row of teeth of the crankshaft sprocket. Once again, you can slightly rotate the shafts to make the alignment process easier. You can do this by using a wrench on the hex feature of the camshafts. As long as the timing marks are all aligned properly when you are finished, your engine will be in time. With the chain installed, install your left-hand chain guide, the tensioner guide, and the upper guide. The left-hand guide bolts torque to 8.7 foot-pounds, and the upper and tensioner guide bolts torque to 16 foot-pounds. Next, install the timing chain tensioner and torque the bolts to 8.7 foot-pounds. Recheck all 3 timing marks. If still aligned properly, activate the tensioner. Before reinstalling the covers, make sure to reinstall the crankshaft reluctor and ensure that you have removed any holding tools that you used during this process. You're now ready to reinstall the oil pan, the valve, and the timing covers. Please follow the proper procedures on applying gasket sealant to the covers and torque all bolts appropriately. Like always, thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please contact our tech line. And to stay up to date with all things Cloyes, including tech and product information and more videos like this one, please sign up for ShopMasters at Cloyes.com.